It's the same story playing out in every village of Haryana. Schoolgirls harassed by hooligans en route to school. From Rewari to Palwal to Kadarpur, Haryana's daughters scream for protection.
हम यहाँ 12वीं तक स्कूल करवाना चाहते हैं क्योंकि वहाँ जाना पड़ता है, वहाँ पर लड़के देखते हैं, लड़कियों को बुरी तरह रहते हैं।
हमारी बहन बादशाहपुर में जाती है, वो 7 किलोमीटर दूर है, वहाँ के टीचर हमारी बहनों से बहुत चिढ़ते हैं।
And while the state of Haryana descends into chaos, the chief minister is busy watching birds at a bird sanctuary. So who will protect the citizens of Haryana?
जिम्मेदारी जो है वो खुद उस लड़की की होती है क्योंकि इस ऐसे रीजन जो ऐसे जो कारण कारण है जो ये सब इन सब को जो वो मतलब घर वाले जो हैं वो यही कहते हैं कि हम रोज रोज जाके वहाँ पे नहीं लड़ सकते स्कूल जो कमाली जाके नहीं लड़ सकते।
But the lawlessness in Haryana isn't the only thing that raises serious questions against the chief minister. We also have him on camera sharing stage with a man who assaulted an old woman.
थाने में गया, थाने में भी इतना गलत शब्द बोले हैं, यहाँ भी इतना बोले हैं, टांग पर टांग धर के मार देंगे, नू मार देंगे।
Over the last few days, Mirror Now has relentlessly been raising these issues, questioning the government, the inaction, the apathy, and we have no answers. With each passing day, the incompetence of the Haryana government becomes more evident, and this time, we demand nothing less than the chief minister's resignation for failing to do the job he was elected for. Mirror Now report.
You're watching the Urban Debate on Mirror Now. I'm Faye D'Souza. Thank you for tuning in. There are schoolgirls across the state of Haryana who took to the streets today to demand basic safety. In 3 different parts of the state over the last couple of days, we've seen schoolgirls protest about the fact that they cannot go to school because they are being eve-teased and molested and harassed on the way. Beti to humne padha liya, bachayega kaun? That's the question we're asking this evening. And to put this into perspective, remember, the reason why we're talking about this is because over the last couple of days, since Saturday last week, stories have been emerging from Haryana on how unsafe the state is. We've raised these questions over and over again. We understand from the Chief Minister's Twitter handle, from his own Twitter handle, that he did have a lot of time yesterday to spend in a bird sanctuary doing what you see on your screen right now. Women are being raped and murdered in your street, in your state, Mr. Khattar. I'm glad you had time to visit the bird sanctuary. Now that you have visited the bird sanctuary, would you please pay a little attention to the safety of women in your state? Students who should be in school are on the street demanding that they be kept safe. In other updates, there's been absolutely no progress in the 2 cases we've been talking about all week. Not only have the police made no arrests in the Rohtak gang rape and murder case, other than the 2 that were already arrested, the police in Haryana have made no arrests and have identified neither the suspects nor the car that was used in the Haryana gang rape, in the Gurgaon gang rape case. Also, to make matters worse, other evidence that's emerging, here is a video of a man, a brother-in-law of a sarpanch in Haryana, mercilessly beating up 2 women. In less than 24 hours, you will see the same man sharing the stage with the chief minister. We'll put up those visuals on your screen in a short minute. Why is it that the chief minister of Haryana is comfortable sharing a stage with someone who you can see on the right of your screen right now, who is comfortable, obviously, with beating women? The same person, less than 24 hours later, sharing a stage with the chief minister. Is the law and order completely crumbling in the state of Haryana? Will the chief minister, who's now done with his visit in the bird sanctuary, actually pay attention to the human beings in his state? That's the question we're asking this evening. Where is the response from the chief minister? Joining me on the show, Raman Malik, spokesperson of the Haryana BJP. Ramakant Gaur is a senior lawyer at the Supreme Court. Brinda Adige, women's rights activist. Purnima Advani, former chairperson of the National Commission for Women. Swapnil Kothari is a senior lawyer in Mumbai. Tripti Desai is a gender equality activist. We also have on the show Neelam Ghatara, who is a social activist who joins us from Delhi. I welcome all of you to the show and I thank you all for your time. Raman Malik, I'm going to start with you. I appreciate the fact that you've come back to give us answers, as you had promised yesterday. Has there been any progress that has been made in either the Rohtak gang rape and murder case, Raman Malik, or the Gurgaon gang rape case?
The investigations are on and they are critical at juncture. As soon as we have something, we will surely update you. It is not that the officers involved in the thing are sleeping. They are on the job. Let them have certain facts which are admissible in the court of law, and they will surely be putting it on.
And in the meanwhile, on the inaction,
remember, I had shared some tweets of the Rohtak IG on your handle, which you must see. So it's not just that the investigation is on, it is also that certain reforms which were required are already in place and they are started on that.
So the two police officers who were suspended for inaction, suspended for not filing the FIR when the girl's parents came to them, yesterday on this panel, Raman Malik, all of the legal experts suggested, quite gently I might add, that the law be followed in this case and these people be dismissed and they be included in the FIR as co-accused. Has that been done?
After the debate, I have taken down those points. I had forwarded. I had not had time. I was not well. I have a cervical problem. I'm still attending your program because it is my duty to answer you back, because the questions that you raised were pertinent and they are of social awakening also. But I have given that to the concerned officers and I'm awaiting an answer from them. Let them do something about it.
Okay, so no update.
And I'll get back to you on that.
Okay, so no update there. Next question, Raman Malik. We see visuals on our screen right now of schoolgirls protesting across the state of Haryana because it's unsafe for them to go to school. They have told us repeatedly and they have spoken to our cameras saying that they are teased, they are molested, they are harassed on the way to school and they demand that they be kept safe. What has the state of Haryana done to keep these girls safe?
Two things. I had a word with the education minister today and with the state DGP also. I have updated them on the current situation. I had suggested them that there should be a very effective transport policy for these children, for these girls, our daughters. And they have agreed to it that they would look into a transport policy which can be looked into in a manner which can safely transport them.
Okay, so no update then. You've suggested something, they've promised to look into it. Now I'm opening up the panel. I'm opening up the panel now for everybody else. I want to start with, we heard out all of your answers. Swapnil Kothari, several problems in the state of Haryana. Several problems.
Yes.
Are you satisfied with the answers?
No, not at all. The first thing, Mr. Malik, I appreciate the fact that you've seem to have now understood the gravity of the fact that the house is on fire and that immediate remedial measures are required. And not only that, but thereafter preventive measures. Suspension of the police officers is not sufficient. You need to dismiss them under Article 311(2)(b) of the Constitution. That is what the Commissioner of the Police should have done instantly. He has all the powers and the prerogative given to him, special powers under the Constitution, to do so. That's the first departmental course that should have been taken. That has not been taken, so I'm a little bit disappointed with that. Because that would have sent a very strong message that if you guys goof up and do not register an FIR, forget 166A, that will take care of, we'll take care of it later, but we'll dismiss you straight away. That's one. And then you do, some of the panelists pointed out yesterday, that co-accused, make them co-accused and file an FIR to that effect. That needed to be done. That well, you know, that seems to be, to me, to be a little bit remote there, given the fact that the affinity that everybody seems to have with each other.
And you know, the problem also is the fact that, and I appreciate Raman Malik's suggestion that he took down the points and he will pass them on. We don't need for you to take down the points from lawyers on our panel and pass them on to the people who are running the state. The people who are running the state need to know that if an FIR has not been filed, that the law has been broken. The fact that this is the route we are taking is extremely distressing. Neelam Katara, the patriarchal attitude in the north of India has meant that girls cannot go to school without being molested, without having their dupattas pulled off, without having someone throwing water on their chest to make their kurtas see through.
This is what girls are going through in Haryana. Please, Faye, I would request you to also add a question to this. Isn't the social fabric also involved in this? Is it not a social issue also?
What is the social fabric you're talking about,
Raman
Malik?
Is no part of the society responsible for this?
What is the social fabric you're talking about? Please tell me. Please explain to me. Neelam, go ahead. Neelam Katara. Neelam Katara, go ahead. Neelam, go ahead.
And let's deal with
education.
Yeah, I am aware about the social fabric and that will take its own time. So let's handle what we can do first. Let's not get into, you know, what may or may not happen for the next decade. So as far as these girls are concerned, definitely there is a patriarchal, you know, mindset there. And as the girls are going out and studying and, you know, becoming more and more independent, this patriarchal mindset feels threatened. And therefore, all these attacks on the girls. Now, first of all, my question, why can't all the secondary schools be immediately with a single order turned into senior secondary schools? It's absolutely possible. So that is one thing which can be done immediately. And everything can be handled, the teachers, the building, we can have second, I mean, you can ask me, I've been teaching for decades. Now, after that, the next thing is about making Haryana and these areas safe. I think we need to have preemptive policing. And you know that I have made the IG or the DG aware. Why is the DG not aware himself? Why do you need Mr. Malik to make him aware? Is he sleeping? So we've got to get into preemptive policing and let us know what the government will do to ensure that such incidents do not occur in the near future.
Absolutely. And our reporter, and I, you know, for the benefit of the panel, I want to play out some of the responses. Our reporter went to the location and met these girls. And our reporter lives in Delhi, so I don't understand why the chief minister or the DG police or anybody in the education department can't make a quick trip to find out what the problem is. Why is it necessary for Raman Malik to have to write a note to the people who are in charge? They should know, after it's been splashed all over the national media, that these girls are in distress. And I want to play out the responses that these girls have given our reporters. They've given very, very vivid details of what happens to them when they go to school. Do we have that ready? Can we play that out, please?
हमें बारी तक अपना स्कूल चाहिए.
स्कूल चाहिए क्यों?
क्योंकि हम दूर जाते हैं, हमारा स्कूल बहुत दूर है, 7 किलोमीटर दूर है, वो बादशाहपुर में है. हमारी बहन बादशाहपुर में जाती है, वो 7 किलोमीटर दूर है. वहाँ के टीचर हमारी बहनों से बहुत चिढ़ते हैं और वो लड़कियों को, बहुसियों को फेल भी कर देते हैं. इस कारण हमें अपना स्कूल यहीं पर करवाना चाहते हैं, 12वीं तक.
हम यहाँ 12वीं तक स्कूल करवाना चाहते हैं क्योंकि वहाँ जाना पड़ता है, वहाँ पर लड़के देखते हैं, लड़कियों को बुरी तरह रहता है और ऑटो की प्रॉब्लम.
I want to bring in the other members of the panel right now. Ramakant Gaur has been on the panel before, given suggestions to the government before. Ramakant Gaur, you heard those voices. And, you know, the evidence that's emerging day after day, just points out to the fact that women are simply not safe at any age. We've seen the fact that the Prenatal Sex Determination Act is being misused in Haryana by the police. From the time women are in the womb, to the time that they're teenagers in school, to the time that they go to work, to the time that they're old women, they're just not safe in the state of Haryana. It is not safe to be a woman in the state of Haryana, Ramakant.
Undoubtedly. See, Mr. Malik talks about social fabric. He has not spoken about the reforms taken by the police. You see, October 2016, a court has reprimanded the police officials for gang rape, and the court had to leave, a court had to acquit all these accused persons for want of evidence. So this is the kind of police investigation there. Police is neither trying to restrain these criminals, and I would name them criminals. It's not about the bad social texture. It is about the criminal mentality. So if the criminal mentality is not being taken seriously, and the police who has to register FIR and has to take action promptly is not doing their duties, so what is the kind of administration being there in that space? I mean, we are living at a place where in 2015 we saw more offenses against the women. In 2016, there was 34% rise in the crime against women. So that's the statistics which we need to see. We cannot simply, simpliciter, shrug off our responsibility and say this is the bad, this is happening due to bad social texture. It is happening because of bad policing as well. We need to take administration on to the task, which is not happening even today. You know, if we dismiss or if we suspend a lower police cadre and without taking into the account of the role of higher police officials who are sleeping, who are so lackadaisical in their approaches, then we cannot expect anything righteous happening there.
Very interesting that you brought up Ramakant Gowd sleeping. Let me give you more evidence, and this is all evidence that has been collected in the last 24 hours. The sub-divisional magistrate, one of the sub-divisional magistrates in Haryana, was at an event where people were airing their grievances. There were women airing their grievances. And I'm going to play this on your screen right now. The woman is seen playing a video game when people are airing their grievances. This just goes to show the seriousness with which people in the state government and in the machinery are dealing with these problems. On one hand, the chief minister is tweeting about the fact that he visited a bird sanctuary and he thought it was very interesting. He's encouraging other people to visit a bird sanctuary. And here we have this woman sitting at an event where people are airing their grievances in Haryana, playing a video game on her phone when she should be listening to what is happening, when she should be listening to the grievances of the people who are sitting in front of her. This is the lackadaisical approach that Ramakant Gowd is talking about. This is the lackadaisical approach that Ramakant Gowd is talking about. Purnima Advani, unfortunately, people who are in positions of power need to take their positions more seriously.
Absolutely. So there are several aspects to this. Number one, those who are in position of power, be it the police, be it those in the Home Ministry, must take their position very seriously, especially so far as crimes against women are concerned. I have not heard from the gentleman who was speaking first whether there is a crime against women cell in the Haryana police. If there is, what are they doing? It is their business to ensure that immediate FIRs are lodged. FIRs should be lodged by a woman police officer preferably. Also, if we are losing the first 6 hours after the incidents, then we are losing important evidence like DNA reports. Is there an adequate forensic science laboratory in Haryana where these samples can go immediately? Because once the matter goes into trial, the court is going to look upon proof beyond reasonable doubt. But here, if there are gaps and gaps, there are going to be doubts and doubts so far as the court is concerned. One of the suggestions of the National Commission for Women has been in the annual confidential report of the police officer, there must be one criteria to say how gender sensitive is the police officer, because these Sarkari Babus, the police officers, know no other language other than what their annual confidential report contains, because their promotions are dependent on that report. Unless and until their promotions are at stake on the issue of crime against women, these talks are just going to remain bald talks and the seriousness is not going to come in. Gender sensitization, of course, has to be introduced on a very, very vigorous footing, because problems in Haryana are not today. They have been in existence since a very, very long time. Am I on screen?
Yes, you are.
Hello?
Yes, you are. We can hear you.
Hello? Okay. Okay, so that's as far as the police is concerned. There should be immediate action taken for failure to file an FIR. Because on the one hand, women in our country are really skeptical about going to file FIRs. Therefore, all that we are seeing about 34% reporting increasing, all this is incorrect in the light of the fact that several women till today do not build up the confidence to go and file an FIR. Therefore, when a woman does go, she must have a very gender-sensitive approach. And she should know that her efforts are not going to
go in vain. But you know, while that's fair, I want to go back to Rahman Malik. Rahman Malik has his hand up. Rahman Malik, everybody is suggesting that you must take immediate action against police. It is not being done. That was the lowest hanging fruit for the state government. You found out that there was inaction. A person was raped and murdered after that inaction. Those people should have been put behind bars. I refuse to call them police officers. They should be put behind bars. You have criminals in uniform. We've proven to you, you have criminals in uniform. Why isn't the state government taking action? And my second question to you, Rahman Malik, I'm sorry, but your state is falling apart. Why is the Chief Minister of Haryana visiting a bird sanctuary instead of realizing the seriousness of the problem in his state?
Okay. Let me answer all the questions that were raised. Number one, we have opened up all 21 districts first. So we have to open up 21 women thanas. We have now put in a scheme of police mitras being there, which are basically citizens being there, so that there's a good connect between the citizen and the police. You must also not forget to mention that over 130 or 140 plus PNDT Act cases were also filed. If as you showed yesterday, there were lapses and there were wrongdoings, those people would not be spared. But the fact of the matter is, there was a very heavy crackdown on the PNDT Act.
They haven't even been suspended.
We should not be forgotten.
You're talking about have not been. They haven't even been suspended. They haven't even been suspended. We ran footage on the screen. I'm going to run one more time of police officers accepting bribes. Police officers accepting bribes for burying cases in the Sex Determination Act. Those police officers have not been suspended. They are still in uniform. Explain to me what you mean when you say action will be taken.
Please understand, we have to sustain the evidence in the court also.
But how will you do it if you keep these people in power?
To sustain the evidence.
How will you sustain evidence by keeping these police officers in their jobs? They have to be removed at least temporarily. They have to be suspended.
Mr. Malik,
There are so many wrong things happening in India. Why don't you just shift your off? Should not go home. You should not do this. You should not do that. You have 10 other things to do in life, and you do it. And you have your own job.
Rahman Malik, I promise you, I'm focused on other states as well. But the evidence coming out of Haryana consistency over the last 1 week is too difficult to ignore. I think you're not answering my question.
It is not at all a private limited company that we are running. It is an organization which is run by the Karyakartas. So they will not take lying down.
What?
Mr. Malik.
Rahman Malik, one second. Rahman Malik, I promise you that we spend all our time focusing on all of the states, and most of the members of this panel have been on this panel repeatedly talking about problems in other states as well. But nothing forgives the fact that women are being raped, murdered in the most gruesome fashion in Haryana. That girls are protesting in the streets because they cannot go to school. Nothing changes the fact that the police are corrupt and the government is not taking action against corrupt police that we have pointed out to you is corrupt. Now, how can you sit here, honestly, with your hand on your heart and tell me that I should ignore the girls who are being raped in the state of Haryana because other things are happening in other parts of the country?
No, I am not at all saying that you should ignore my daughters. Number one. Number two, there is a particular format under which the upgradation is done. The Gurgaon case has been already recommended for upgradation. It's under process. The Palwal thing The distance between the Palwal school and the other higher school, senior secondary school, is hardly 2.5 kilometers. There are certain realignments required. That is number
one. No, you have to stop them from being molested in the street.
We must not forget that this also is a problem because of the education system that was there. The education system always never bothered to give the social studies. Which were required.
Stop them from being molested in the street. It's a very simple answer. It's a very simple answer.
Mr. Malik.
I'm opening this up to the rest of the panel as well. Please don't wait for me to call upon you. Go ahead.
Yeah, Mr. Malik, there are one or two reservations that I have with the observations that you just made. First of all, you talked about the fact that, you know, the admissibility of the evidence is an issue before you dismiss people or before you take some action against the corrupt police officers. I think that video camera, which we are just seeing on our TV, and I'm sure you have a TV in front of you, that itself is sufficient evidence. There is something as that's plain straight evidence. That should be enough to nail a person, one. And it's completely admissible. Second aspect, which I'm talking about, is that there were, you know, the woman in question, the Rohtak rape victim, was battered, tattered. And, you know, it's a question of presumptive evidence. There is only one presumption to that. There is a concept of presumptive evidence in law, and that means it's a rape. There is nothing else. Now, when you have these two things, a presumptive evidence and a plain straight evidence, which is apparent here from the TV, I don't think it should take much time. And the fact that you are mentioning now, as far as the commute of 7 kilometers is concerned, and you are, you know, envisaging a transport policy. Now, this is something which should have been done quite some time ago. And after listening to the panelists, it's great of you to, you know, take down notes and inform the people. But I think if the people in administration and occupying high positions of power need to be informed by a debate and by a channel and by you, then I think I would completely call it as a banana state, a failed state. And I'm sure you're not going to like this, but do you really want at some stage a president's rule to be imposed?
So are we supposed, sir, to call the IS officers, the IS and IPS officers running the state,
right,
as state secretariats and other places as bananas?
Not at all.
Of the Republic?
Not at all. I would not call them.
If you're talking about the quality of life in your state, Raman Malik, listen to these girls. Listen to these children in your state. And then I'm going to go to Tripti Desai, and I can see the other hands coming up. Listen to these girls.
When you start,
वहाँ से जब आते तो वो ऑटो वाले ऐसे कभी लाते कभी नहीं, बहुत प्रॉब्लम होते घर पे आके शाम को 4-5 बजे ऐसे लगते हैं, और इसलिए हमें बहुत दिक्कत होते हैं। राह में कोई कई लड़के जो लड़कों को भी छेड़ते, हमने ऐसे, हमारे साथ हुआ तो नहीं पर हमने बहुत ज़्यादा ऐसे देखा है। अपने पेरेंट्स को बनाया ताकि वो हमें स्कूल भेजे, हम कुछ बनना चाहते हैं इसलिए, बस इसलिए।
आप क्या बनना चाहते हो बड़े हो?
मैं CA बनना चाहती हूँ, CA करना चाहती हूँ, अपने पेरेंट्स का हाथ बटाना चाहती हूँ ताकि उन्हें कभी किसी चीज़ के लिए और परेशानी ना हो।
तो वो आके देंगे ना हमें सुरक्षा, बार बैठे बैठे थोड़ी ना सुरक्षा मिलती है, आ कर दे हमें सुरक्षा, हम यहाँ से उठ जाएंगे।
तृप्ति देसाई, गर्ल्स हू से आई कन्विंस्ड माई पेरेंट्स टू सेंड मी टू स्कूल, आई वॉन्ट टू बिकम अ CA. But I can't go to school because boys are bothering me on the way. Auto drivers are bothering me on the way. People are molesting me on the way. This is the truth. Tripti Desai, yehi sachai hai Haryana ki.
बिल्कुल, ये हरियाणा हो या अलग ये जो स्टेट्स है, यहाँ पे वही चल रहा है। मुझे रमन जी को कहना है कि आपने बीजेपी सरकार आने के बाद कहा था कि महिलाओं के लिए अच्छे दिन आने वाले, तो ये है महिलाओं के लिए अच्छे दिन? गैंगरेप हो रहे हैं, रेप करके मर्डर किए जा रहे हैं, उसके बाद भी CM जो है वो उसमें दखल अंदाजी नहीं ले रहे। आज आप देख रहे हैं कि सिटीजन्स की उनको कुछ लेना देना नहीं है, वो बर्ड पार्क देखने जा रहे हैं, और महिलाएं आज स्टूडेंट्स रास्ते पे उतर रही है। ग्रामीण भाग में विलेज में जब देखते हैं कि 5-5, 10-10 किलोमीटर कॉलेज में जाना पड़ता है, क्यों का अपग्रेड जो है स्कूल्स नहीं हो रहा है, इसमें क्यों जो है वो गवर्नमेंट नहीं आगे आ रही है? महिलाओं को सिर्फ अभी जो हमने आपने दिखाया कि बेटी बचाओ बेटी पढ़ाओ, ये जो अभियान शुरू हुआ है, बेटी हम बचाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं और बेटियां पढ़ रही है, आगे आ रही है, लेकिन उसको गवर्नमेंट जो है वो सपोर्ट नहीं कर रहा है। और जब ये महिलाएं जो है वो पीड़ित महिलाएं जब पुलिस स्टेशन जाती है, पुलिस जो है वो वहां पे डिले करती है, पुलिस जो है वो FIR दर्ज नहीं करती है, गुंडों के ऊपर जो है वो ध्यान दिया जाता है लेकिन महिलाओं को गलत बोला जाता है, तो ये बिल्कुल सब जगह गलत चल रहा है। इसलिए बीजेपी सरकार ने जो महिलाओं के लिए अच्छे दिन लाने का वादा किया था, मुझे लगता है कि ये बिल्कुल अच्छे दिन नहीं है और हरियाणा के सीएम ने जो है वो तुरंत रिजाइन करना चाहिए क्योंकि उन्होंने उनकी जिम्मेदारी बिल्कुल नहीं निभाई है।
ब्रिंदाडी के, डू यू एग्री?
आई अग्री विद तृप्ति। आई ऑल्सो हैव अ क्वेश्चन टू मिस्टर रमन, वॉट इज द प्रोफेशनलिज्म ऑफ द पुलिस? Because this kind of teasing, this kind of molestation is not something that happened day before yesterday or today. This has been happening for a long time. And I'm sure girls and the students have been making the complaints. So what is your beat system? What have you done regarding sensitizing the police to tell them that this is something that you need to keep a lookout on so that the girls are safe? They go to school and come back home safe. Having a transport that ferries them from home to school is fine, but they are not going to be all the time in that transport. At some point, they are going to be walking around to the market, to the temple, to the Gurudwara. What happens at that time? Will the police continue to say, we will give you a transport? We are looking at safety of girls in the entire public spectrum of Haryana.
Well, Megha Chatterjee has called us. Megha Chatterjee is a student, I understand. Megha, go ahead, we can hear you. How old are you? Megha?
Yes.
Go ahead, Megha. We can hear you on the panel. Go ahead. How old are you and what would you like to say?
Yes, I'm just a 13-year-old girl calling from Mumbai, Maharashtra.
Okay.
I'm seeing this debate.
Yes. Go ahead, Megha. We can hear you.
Yes. Okay. I'm just a 13-year-old girl calling from Mumbai, Maharashtra. And
Megha, we can hear you.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
Megha, we can hear you. Go ahead. Okay. Tell us what you want to say.
So, I just saw this debate and I feel that it's very sad that Haryana is gender biased like this. Okay? It's very sad. The law has to be strengthened. Yesterday I was seeing the CCTV footage of policemen taking bribe and it's just very sad that even the police are like that. They've got a certain amount of power in their hands, and if they misuse it this way, think about the impact that will fall on the people.
Look at that, Mr. Raman Malik. Mr. Raman Malik, do you need suggestions from a 13-year-old girl who thinks it's sad? It's sad the manner in which the state of Haryana is run. Shall we send this message to the Chief Minister, Mr. Khattar, because he obviously, at his bird sanctuary visit, has not got our message yet, Mr. Raman Malik? Shall we have more 13-year-old girls call Mr. Khattar and tell him that his state of affairs is currently sad, Raman Malik? I can see Neelam Khatara's hand go up. Neelam Khatara, go ahead.
Yes, possibly in a state where the Chief Minister has not led his party to victory, he doesn't feel that kind of connect with the people, and the people, obviously he doesn't seem to care for them. Now, I know very well that in our country you are innocent until proven guilty, and I also know a lot of accusations on politicians are because of, just wait Mr. Malik, are because of political reasons, but this is a country where we have rape accused sitting in the parliaments, in the legislatures, in the legislative councils. So, I mean, can't we in this 125 crore Deshvasiyon ka desh, can't we just ask all these people who are accused, and I'm only talking of rape, not of murder, kidnapping, to step down? Will this government with a brute majority in the parliament not bring a rule saying that no one with charges of rape will contest election in the next general election or in any of the state elections? We need to say this. They may be innocent till proven guilty, but we expect a higher degree of probity from our lawmakers. If it hurts their democratic rights to be asked to stay out of the parliament or the legislative assemblies, it hurts our democratic rights and the democratic rights of this 13-year-old kid that she has to live in a country where laws are made by people who may be guilty of rape. Have them all step down on one day, and if this government means business, इफ दे रियली वॉन्ट टू से बेटी बचाओ, ऑर्डिनेंस लाएं कि जितने लोग पार्लियामेंट या लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबलीज में बैठे हैं वो कल स्टेप डाउन कर जाएं अगर वो रेप से अक्यूज है, रेप के लिए, तो आप देखिएगा फर्क,
क्योंकि जो भी मिस्टर मलिक कह रहे हैं उन्होंने सब ट्राई कर दिया,
ये लो वो थाना वो थाना, कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ रहा.
We want action. I completely agree with you and I'll go one step further.
I hope the Prime Minister is listening to हमारे मन की बात.
I completely agree with you and I'll go one step further and I'm taking this to Amit King का Women's Reservation Bill. The people making laws in this country. Where is the Women's Reservation Bill? Why can't we have women in Parliament? Why? What is so scary about having more women in Parliament? Why are we afraid of the Women's Reservation Bill? Amit Khemka.
In respect of Haryana, it is very clear that there is a mindset, especially in Haryana, which is absolutely a man-centric mindset. You showed a clip in which the girl is saying the teachers are exploiting. The teachers are exploiting. They are giving marks according to the favors received. Now, forget about police, what police might have done or what we know the police is very incompetent. The government is not ready to do anything. What has the government done about these teachers? He is talking that we have not given education. Now, if you are going to such a school where a girl student has to give favors to the teacher in order to get marks, what are we up to? And what is the action government has taken on that? And if it is so widespread that every child there is saying so, and on the way they are being teased, in the school they are being teased. Now, it is something horrible. It is more horrible than rape itself. Because if you have to live every day, morning, evening, day and night, that is starting from your home to school, on the way, in the school. Now it is something very, very horrible. I think the minister or whatever is the spokesperson, they should be ashamed. You should think of doing something about it rather than debating even. And look at the police. Why can't you say that all pot-bellied policemen will tomorrow morning go out of the job? If a policeman is not fit, what do you think? Will he be mentally fit if he is not physically fit? Why don't you remove all of them? Can you have an army officer who is not physically fit? How can you have a policeman who is not physically fit? You don't do anything about it. You don't equip them. Not only that, you don't train them.
And you know, Amit Khemka, we're not even talking about their physical fitness. We're talking about their legal fitness. The fact that they're on camera receiving, accepting bribes. And they have not even been suspended,
everybody,
Amit Khemka.
Not every
even
person,
been suspended.
Every person who is
can
corrupt
I now answer?
Would also be physically
I have to
unfit.
Keep listening to this propaganda.
Oh, this is not propaganda. Please,
what
Raman
is
Malik,
propaganda?
Please,
what
this
is
not propaganda. I don't know what you're talking about. In fact, I would want to credit this panel for being extremely calm.
You 500 girls protesting that you put on the
team. That is one.
Second, this is the only state which has given you the right to file a police complaint. And Mrs. Katara, please listen to this.
No,
this is the only state which has given a right
to
a citizen to file a police complaint even sitting in New York. So
they
this,
are not supposed
this
to file a police complaint.
This is also there, which
you
have never been spoken about.
Of it.
You are not speaking about
you
the fact that even a fatwi or a maulvi or a priest has been found
you
doing misdoings,
do
and those people
a
have
girl,
been, you have never
you
taken
expect,
that
you
part on.
Like being
why have you not taken that part
going
on?
Filing a complaint? What is this?
This is not the way you create an awareness in the society. This is today because of this government that these daughters have the courage to come and question the establishment. It is not about your efforts. It is about the efforts of this government which has gone to the grassroots level. Telling the girls, please talk about it. This is what we have done. This is not about your awareness. This is the awareness of this government that has gone to the grassroots level.
You cannot possibly be taking credit for the protest, saying that you've given these girls enough courage to come out and protest against you.
I don't know, sometimes it is because of what the other governments have not done. Sometimes it is because of what this government has done. We are very grateful.
Come forward and talk, even if it is your father who is doing something wrong. Come forward and talk.
You know, and let me, okay, Raman Malik, 500 students is an underestimate. Three different schools have protested in Haryana over the last... Purnima, I see your hand come up. I am going to come to you. 500 students is actually an underestimate.
Yes,
I told my team to underestimate.
It is democracy. You are allowed to protest.
So, and I'm allowed to report to that protest. There's nothing wrong. Students came out and protested, and it is my job to tell that story.
The government. It is not wrong way. Let's address to the issue. You are making it that government
is Malik,
that
is, I am not saying stop the protest. Please, you seem to completely misunderstand me.
What about the social problem? What about the problem which has come from the back?
To rebut your second point of this is the only state that allows you. You use the word allow. This is which is my fundamental right to be one of my rights to be able to file a complaint. You said this is the only state that allows you to file a complaint from wherever
yes,
you are.
The Constitution
Let me play this evidence.
You.
One second. Let me play
and
this evidence. This is the Rosa gang rape victim's
you.
Father.
And the
this is what he said about what happened.
Raman
Malik, calm down. We heard you out. This is what he said about what happened when he went to file a complaint about his daughter being molested.
No. This is not the way. I have to. You are six people. I have to respond. I will respond to each and every one.
Nobody's going to stop you. I want to play this clip for my panel and for my viewers. When Raman Malik says, this is the only state that allows you to file an FIR anywhere because you can do it on the internet. I don't know how many people in Haryana actually know this, but if they
on
did...
On her samay, the internet platform, you can file a complaint anywhere or from the world.
In the world?
May I ask a question?
Please go ahead.
Have you got any specific data whereby these internet complaints have been turned into FIR? You see, I'm the witness to it. Being a lawyer, I can say that
they
authoritatively. Just a minute, sir. If you are so equipped, please show us the data.
Sir.
And if you don't have the data, please bear to listen with. So basically, if you don't have the data, and then more particularly, in a situations where victims go to the police stations and your police officials do not even... Yeah, please.
Right, Purnima Advani, go ahead. Purnima Advani, I'm sorry, I will come back. I will come back to you, Mr. Gaur. Purnima Advani, go ahead.
Let's have some clarity in the whole picture. A, I see there's more concern about protecting the police officer and collecting evidence when prima facie the evidences are clear, rather than collecting quick evidence so far as a crime is concerned. Because this is a crime where, in rape I'm talking about, the moment we lose crucial evidence because of waste of time, delay in collection of evidence, I'm talking of forensic evidence here, we are losing proof which is going to be crucial to give justice to that victim. That is number one. Number two, what is all this talk about internet Agreed. Happening when we are seeking to protect that girl who is still not able to go to school? She is not able to go to her 5th standard, 6th standard, 7th standard. What kind of internet usage is she going to resort to? When you have a police thana in whom you have a police officer who is not willing to file an FIR, which internet, lo and behold, are we looking at? I don't think we are catering only to the luxurious, sophisticated elite of Haryana. Are we not catering to the majority of the state where you have women below poverty line? There is no question of their coming near a computer in order to click the right button.
Yes, yes.
Why don't we have some clarity in which society are we aiming at? Which women are we aiming at? Why don't we talk when we are talking of women empowerment? We are not letting her go to school. That's number one. Number two, is transport the only way in which they can be protected? This is a multi-pronged approach where, more than anything else, the first message required is to that police officer sitting in a police thana that if you are not gender sensitive and you do not file the FIR when a victim of crime comes to you, your job is gone. Otherwise, we are just not giving the right message.
Let me play out this clip for you. And I want, and I know Raman Malik has heard this at least 5 or 6 times, but for the rest of our panelists, this is what happens in Haryana. So we're not talking about using the internet from New York. The women in your state, Raman Malik, are not using the internet from New York. They're begging to be allowed to go to school. Let's listen to this.
हमारी मिसिज गई थी वहाँ रिकॉर्ड दर्ज कराने, तो इतनी उनकी आजकल लेडीज को भी फोन सुनाई करता है जी, वैसे गरीब आदमी होते थे, वैसे बातों में धमका फुचका के उनको ऐसे ही भेज देते हैं जी, तो उनका कोई सुनाई नहीं हुई थी उस टाइम।
We acknowledge that there was a complaint which was given by the victim's mother in city police station, and there was a compromise also which was struck, and they did not want police action further. That is what our report say, but the special investigation team will also look into this matter.
Jaya is on the phone from Mumbai. Jaya, very quickly, go ahead.
Yes, I would like to emphasize that first, the lodging of FIR should be, have no time limit at all. The minute the person goes, it should be lodged, because right. justice delayed is justice denied. One, right. we must increase the policing. We must have voluntary organizations, and the credentials where transport is assured by your Minister of Haryana, we must see that there can be big buses, because the autobolas will again be the local people, and right. Drivers' credentials must be verified, and all the schools on must immediately be upgraded. And but these problems right. are going right. to exist even later for their undergraduation.
Right, and you know, let me I understand what you're saying, Jaya. I want to acknowledge the fact that Raman Malik has come back to this show every day this week to answer our questions. I will acknowledge that he has patiently heard us all out. Raman Malik, there are very clear checkpoints that have to be achieved for the Beti Padhao, Beti Bachao Andolan. How much of that have we actually achieved? We've seen the sex ratio of Haryana. It's abysmal. The focus on literacy, the empowerment of women. And now girls actually saying that they can't go to school. Raman Malik, please, you've heard everybody out. What is your answer?
Please strengthen. Please strengthen your state women's commission and ensure that it is an autonomous body which doesn't dance to the tune.
Right, state women's commission. Raman Malik, go ahead.
Yeah. So first and foremost, let me put it out to the panelists that you have. The basic point is that the state had certain problems which are not denied. There were certain social problems also which are not denied. That is why this Andolan was started from here. We have remarkably done. There may be 999 or 999 cases which would have been protected, solved, cleared. But there are going to be few cases which are there. And that is where we get the feedback to rectify. And how to rectify and what is to be rectified. That is governance. That is number one. Number two, the IG Rohtak, and I had tagged you in that particular tweet and your channel also on the Twitter, that after this particular case, then the IG Range Rohtak, he personally took that all people involved should immediately undergo a systematic training program where they are sensitized on the fact that how you should handle these cases.
After someone is dead, Mr. Malik, after someone is dead, to tell me that you are using this case of this girl who was ripped limb for limb.
That has already been, I have given you a copy.
You're using it as a learning experience?
IG Rohtak did not take any action.
Mr. Malik, I've got a couple of points to make. Mr. Gaur, may I finish, please? Thank you very much.
It will take time.
Raman Malik, I'm sorry. I can't give you time, first of all, because I've run out of time. Secondly, because you cannot sit here after a week and tell me that you're going to use these cases as learning experiences for your police officers. They should have learned in police training. And if they have not learned, they belong behind bars. Raman Malik, I'm sorry.
Even if it is a police officer, neta, abhineta, common citizen, some saint, somebody, nobody would be spared.
You keep saying that,
Mr. Malik, if you hear me
there
out,
was an IG on your
no, Mr. Malik. Unfortunately, I have to wrap up this conversation, but this is where we are. Rohtak gang rape and murder case, no progress, no update. Gurgaon gang rape case, no progress, no update. Corrupt policemen taking money to bury cases in the Sex Determination Act, no progress, no update, no suspension, no arrest. State Chief Minister completely missing in action unless it's a visit to a bird sanctuary. and Haryana's girls are demanding better service. Look at them, they are out on the street. Look at them, they're protesting. Look at those citizens, they're demanding their rights. Your time is up, Mr. Khattar. Your time is up. This is what your citizens feel about you. And unless you step down, because we've run out of patience now. Unless you step down, these citizens are going to demand that you do so. Because look at them. They have no patience for you and neither do we. We've waited an entire weekend to tell us now on Friday that you're using this as a learning experience to train your policemen. Are you joking? That girl was raped and murdered. And she was run over. Shame on you. Shame on all of you. You have absolutely no heart. And you have no business being in public office. Shame on you.